A bullpup gun is a weapon where the action is located behind the trigger, which was initially done as a way to make the gun more compact and mobile. Now, most bullpup weapons will also have the magazine behind the trigger instead of in front of it, and there have been some pretty insane bullpup weapons throughout COD history. Well, welcome back to one of those mega insane ranking lists, everybody. Jimmy or Chaos, today we are going to be doing a two-part episode ranking all 71 bullpup weapons in COD history. I know, it's a lot. We're going to rank them from dead last all the way to the best. So you let me know which of these was your favorite. Drop a like, turn on those notifications as always, and it's time to show the bullpup some love. I don't think we've actually ever done this. At number 71, dead last, the HS10 in Black Ops 1. Did you even know this was a bullpup? I've been talking a lot of crap on this gun lately, but I mean, let's be real. It was awful. It wasn't useless, but it was definitely not anybody's first choice, second choice, or fifth choice. A semi-auto shotgun that could hold four shells at a time, and you had to reload each one of them individually. It was literally just a worse version of the Spaz. I mean, the damage wasn't there, the range wasn't there, the accuracy wasn't there, and the ammo capacity, it made it more of a liability more often than not. Definitely a lower tier bullpup in COD history, and if you ask me, it's the worst. Guys, if you are getting anything from G2A.com, use code CHAOS, get some cash back, whether it be game code or anything, a gift card, take advantage. The link is at the top of the description. At number 70, the S12 in Black Ops 2. This is one of my least favorite shotguns in COD history, and that works well here because it's a bullpup. Semi-auto shotgun, extremely low damage, horrible range, and a long reload animation to keep it balanced. Now, it was technically capable of a one-shot kill, but the range was super, super bad, so if your target backed up even a little bit, it was a marshmallow shooter. It was crap all around, and unless you're playing hardcore modes, it was unviable. The damage at point-blank range was decent, but the range was just way too punishing to justify taking it instead of one of the other shotties in Black Ops 2, and once again, it was a bullpup. At number 69, the RSA Interdiction in Black Ops 3. Now, it was a supply drop weapon. People lost their minds, but once the community got to play with it, you realized it wasn't anything special. Bolt-action sniper was the only one in Black Ops 3 to have aim assist, which made it super desirable out the gate, but it was a way to balance out the accuracy. Treyarch gave it a teeny tiny one-shot kill range, and they also slowed down that fire rate. It was one of the worst snipers in the game, despite being a bolt-action with aim assist. The Locust and the SVG were way more reliable. Yes, they were harder to get good with, but they were so much better from a damage standpoint. You were better off just putting in the work and putting in the time and never using the RSA. At number 68, the QBB LSW in Black Ops 2. Now, I've said a few times that this gun was kind of pointless, and I stand by that. Very fast firing, had a decent time to kill, but it was basically just an LMG variant of the Type 25, and it was worse in every way. The recoil was higher, the handling was slower, the range was pretty much the same, and there wasn't anything about the QBB that made it worth using. I mean, it had the handling of an LMG, but the stats implied you were supposed to rush people and play aggressive with, which wasn't going to happen. It was kind of a pointless gun. At number 67 today, the FHR-40 in Infinite Warfare. This was supposed to be the futuristic P90, but it ended up just being a crappy SMG that nobody wanted. Had an extremely high fire rate and a very big magazine, but it also had some ridiculous recoil and painfully low damage. Now, despite being one of the fastest firing guns in all of IW, the time to kill, it was terrible, which makes no sense. I mean, the big magazine was practically a necessity due to all the hit markers you were going to get. Now, in hardcore modes, viable most everything is. In core, terrible. Total crap. At number 66, the WA 2000 in Black Ops 1. You remember it. Did you know it was a bullpup? The sniping in Black Ops 1 was pretty bad on its own, but, I mean, the WA, it was one of the least used snipers in the game, and that was saying something. Semi-auto sniper, inconsistent damage, pretty awkward handling, little smiley face on the lens cap, that was the cool part of it. It wasn't as bad as the Dragunov, but it wasn't near as good as the PSG or the L96. It wasn't anybody's weapon of choice. You're lying if you say it was. I know there's going to be somebody in the comments, the WA 2000 was crazy, Jimmy, you don't know what you're talking about, get good. No. At number 65. The L86 LSW in Modern Warfare 2. Now, all the guns in Modern Warfare 2 were viable, we know that. But this was the least used and for good reason. Solid fire rate, would kill in 3 bullets, but it had an extremely high recoil and pretty obstructive iron sights, which made it pretty hard to use other weapons, okay? Plus, it was an LMG, so the handling was super slow compared to everything else in Modern Warfare 2. And Modern Warfare 2 was all about snappy guns that could kill super quickly, and while the L86 had good time to kill, the handling was the death of it. It moved super slow, kicked way too much, and compared to every other automatic weapon in Modern Warfare 2, it just did not have a role to fill. at number 64 today. The XM25 in Modern Warfare 3. Do you guys remember this? It was a bullpup grenade launcher that was kind of complicated. Out of the gate when we saw it, we were like, holy cow, this is going to be overpowered. You could fire 4 shots before reloading. When you aim down the sights, you could actually mark the distance you wanted the grenade to travel. And did I mention it was a fully automatic, full auto grenade launcher with a scope on it? I mean, what could go wrong here? Well, the grenades were super weak, the blast radius was small, and getting one-hit kills was actually rare. And since it couldn't lock onto enemy killstreaks, what's the point of the weapon? It looked cool, it sounded cool, but nobody ever used it. At number 63 today, the Odin in Modern Warfare 2019. It's definitely a fun weapon to mess around with, but if you're playing standard multiplayer, not so much. It was insanely strong, and it might actually be one of the strongest ARs in COD history in terms of bullet damage, so where's the problem? Well, the handling's the problem, the fire rate's the problem. I mean, it fires at 435 rounds per minute, and you still need at least 2 shots to get somebody down, so you can see, I mean, the time to kill, it just face plants here. In Warzone, people have figured out how to make the Odin work in their favor, but in standard multiplayer, it's bad. At number 62, the AUG H-Bar in Modern Warfare 2. This is one of the less popular versions of the AUG from COD history. Most people don't even remember it. It was an LMG this time, so it wasn't as popular as some of the others, but it did have potential. It would deal a flat 40 damage, so it was a 3-shot kill no matter what, and the recoil was pretty low, so once again, where is the problem? Well, the fire rate was on the low side, and Modern Warfare 2, we already talked. Snappy guns, handling speeds, you needed something that could kill quick. It was nice to have an LMG that reloaded quickly, but the drawbacks of the weapon in action were the main things that brought it down. You just weren't going to use a weapon that handled this slowly in a game as fast as MW2. At number 61, the TAC-12 in Ghosts. Shotties were pretty bad all around in Ghosts because of the large map design. Nobody was rushing in small quarters, so there really wasn't a point in taking a shotgun with you. Case in point, the TAC-12. It could delete you with a single shot, yes, but when you backed up to about 13 meters, the pellets would disappear into thin air and you'd be spitting at the enemy. It had decent shots for a shotgun in terms of damage and handling, but the range was so bad and the map design of Ghosts, it just did not complement shotgun players. I mean, it didn't. But it was a bullpup weapon, so here it is. At number 60, the WA 2000 in Modern Warfare 2. It first appeared in Modern Warfare 2. It wasn't awful, it was just outclassed by other snipers. Semi-automatic, pretty inconsistent damage, rather small magazine. The main problem of this one was the fact that it didn't serve a purpose. If you wanted a one-shot kill machine, you took the Intervention. If you wanted a semi-auto spam machine, you took the Barrett 50 cal. The WA just didn't have a purpose in there. It didn't. It was unique. The firing sound was cool, but nobody was using it. There was no point. And speaking of that, at number 59, you're going to be so upset. The F2000 in Modern Warfare 2. Yep, I don't like it. I know some of you do, but I don't. And consider I made a video not too long ago where I called it the worst gun in that game, you should probably know what I'm going to say here. It was viable, I guess, but it was severely outclassed by every other rifle in the game, every single one. The other rifles either killed faster or way easier to use due to lower recoil, cleaner sights, better mobility. I could go on all day. It was basically a clunky SMG, and it didn't even stand up to the SMGs very well. So there. Yeah. I mean, honestly, if you're an F2000 lover, you should probably be happy I didn't put it lower. At number 58, here we go again. The FAD in Modern Warfare 3, the last gun unlocked. Come on. It wasn't awful, but it wasn't good. Fantastic fire rate, yes. Close range damage was good, but the recoil was high and the damage, once you got a little farther back and it's an AR, it just wasn't good. I think the FAD had some potential in hardcore modes, but then again, like I said, what does it? I think 58's a fair spot for it. I actually kind of should have put it farther back. At number 57, the SMR in Black Ops 2. It's not a bad gun on its own, but in the context of Black Ops 2, it was pointless. Semi-auto rifle, low recoil, consistent 2-shot kill. And you know what else was semi-auto with low recoil and 2-shot kill? The FAL. But the FAL had better iron sights, higher fire rate, faster reload animation. So why would you ever take the SMR? It was pointless. It was. I know some people insist the gun was underrated, but when a rifle is outclassed in literally every category by another rifle, I don't know what else to say. At number 56, the Lynx in COD Ghosts. Now, the Lynx was a pretty unpopular pick in Ghosts because of its atrocious handling speeds. It was a semi-auto sniper with good one-shot kill potential, but in a game with such a fast time to kill, those handling speeds were going to get you in trouble. At long range, it was good, but the mobility kept it from being versatile like the USR or whatever else you were using in Ghosts at that time. Ghosts had really good sniping mechanics, and the gunplay was good. I don't know. The Lynx. At number 55, the Atlas 20mm in Advanced Warfare. This was awesome to look at, but in practice, it was a mixed bag. shoulder-mounted sniper that was almost always a one-shot kill, but it came at the cost of low mobility and high recoil. And the accuracy was once again a mixed bag as well. It was up there. The sway was up there. The field of view was super low. If you didn't hit your first shot, you were in trouble. Now, granted, if you did hit your first shot, you were probably going to win the engagement. Like I said, a mixed bag. Bullpup. At number 54, the SVU and Ghost. It's another Ghost rifle that wasn't very popular. It was a marksman rifle. It would kill in two bullets from any distance, and it fired in semi-automatic mode. Now, the fire rate cap was low, and the recoil was pretty noticeable, so it was awkward. If it fired quicker and the recenter was a little faster, it probably would have been a really good marksman rifle for the larger maps, but since neither of those ever happened, it's kind of just sitting there. I'm willing to bet some of you forgot the gun was in the game. I mean, a lot of the marksman rifles, most of them didn't get much field usage in Ghost. At number 53, the Lynx in Advanced Warfare. Just slightly better in AW than it was in Ghost, but that's not good. It did significantly less damage than its Ghost counterpart, and it was more of a DMR than a sniper. It was a very stable weapon. If you were crouched and prone, it was good. But if you got up, that sway and recoil was pretty bad. And even after that, you had to hit people twice to drop them unless you got a headshot, and that wasn't going to happen very often. It wasn't terrible, but it wasn't great. Here we go. Are you ready? 52. The Cheekum CQB in Black Ops 2. I don't like the gun. I know there's going to be people insist in the comment section it was good. I don't care. 3-round burst SMG. Did have a really good time to kill if you hit all your shots, but that TTK was beaten out by most of the other automatic SMGs in the game, so what's the point? It also sounded horrible, so I couldn't take it seriously. I know some people liked it, but I'm not one of them. It got the number 52 spot, and once again, I feel like that's being very, very nice. At number 51, the S12 in Advanced Warfare. Now, it was better in Advanced Warfare than it was Black Ops 2, but that's not saying a whole lot. It was a full auto this time around. It could deal a lot more damage, but it was also in a game where shotguns suffered. People barely used the shotties in Advanced Warfare. Why would they? The movement. I mean, the Bulldog was about the only one that was ever used, so yeah, it's kind of there. At number 50 today, the FAD and Ghosts. Now, the FAD returned in Ghosts, and it was significantly better than in Modern Warfare 3. Granted, that's not saying a lot either, but at least it was a little more versatile this time. Great fire rate, decent damage. It did have some quirks to it in the handling department. It wasn't going to outgun other rifles at long range or the SMGs at close range, but it was viable in most situations, which gave it some longevity in the grand scheme of things. Definitely better than the Modern Warfare 3 version, but still mid-tier. At number 49 today, the Spitfire in Black Ops 4. Now, when this game came out, people thought it was going to be the new Scorpion Evo, but it wasn't. It had impressive fire rate, yes. Had a good time to kill, but the recoil was high. The range wasn't very good, especially in a game with a longer time to kill like BO4. Up close, it was a monster. Mid-range and longer, it wasn't. It was way too hard to control, and the amount of shots you need to kill somebody was too many, unless you were on Nuketown. At number 48, the SA-87 in Modern Warfare 2019. A lot of people have written this gun off over the last year. I don't think it's amazing, but I don't know if it should be written off. I mean, let's give it credit. It was an LMG with a 30-round mag and a rather low rate of fire, but extremely high damage and pretty manageable recoil. Handling speed slow, yes. Fire rate a little annoying, yes. Damage, though, off the charts. Reload animation, pretty quick. Plus, you could get a 50 or 60-round mag on it, and you could just spray and pray. That's what I do. It's not high tier, but it wasn't bad. At number 47, the MSBS and Ghost. Now, launch day, it would have been number one. It was essentially the COD 4 M16, but better. Infinity Ward nerfed it fast, though, and then you never saw it again. Following the nerfs, it was rather inconsistent as a rifle. It did have some annoying accuracy quirks, but it didn't work. It was broken on launch day, but then it got nerfed into the ground, and it was one of the least used rifles in the game. At number 46, the VKS in Ghost. Come on, it's a sniper with an integrated suppressor. That's cool, but what do you get in exchange for that? Well, it could kill with a single shot to the head, but the handling was odd. The potential was good, and the suppressor was a nice addition, but unless you were playing hardcore modes, a VKS was a mixed bag. Sometimes, you would insta-kill somebody. Sometimes, you would fire a shot and hit somebody, and they walk away. It had potential on paper. It was just super inconsistent. At number 45 today, the Type 25 in Black Ops 2. It's a controversial weapon because people seem to either love it or hate it. I'm on the fence. It had a very fast fire rate, but it took a lot more shots to kill than other rifles in Black Ops 2. Plus, it kicked quite a bit. It really did. It could get you in trouble. It wasn't bad. It just wasn't great. It was viable. There's just a lot of other guns that got the job done better. I think this is fair. At number 44, the SDK 9mm in COD World War II. Another sniper rifle with an integrated suppressor. Which was nice in a game like COD World War II that didn't have a lot of attachments. Smooth handling, solid fire rate, big default mag. There was a downside though. The damage. As a way to balance out that suppressed firepower, it had a rather small one-shot kill range, meaning you had to be really consistent in order to take full advantage. It was the whole get good mentality. At number 43, I forgot this gun existed. The UDM in Infinite Warfare, the machine pistol that was, it was a popular secondary, I believe, and yeah, 14 round mag by default, fired somewhat slowly, but the damage was high, and which that made it great for a secondary. You could swap out, finish off a damaged enemy. It could even keep up with some of the SMGs at close range, although the magazine was super, super tiny. Good secondary, and we're now at the point in the video where every gun is probably going to be viable. At number 42, the P90 in Modern Warfare 3. The first of the few P90s on this list, this version was the weakest. It wasn't bad, but it was the weakest. It fired at 900 rounds per minute, came with a 50-round mag, which was nice, and it could kill in as little as 3 bullets. You could even throw extended mags on it to bring it up to this ridiculous 75 rounds. The range wasn't great. It became kind of a marshmallow shooter at range, but it had bullet hose nature, so it was okay. Not as good as some of the other SMGs in MW3, but it was good. And the final one today, at number 41, the HLX-4 in Black Ops 3, a supply drop SMG that featured one of the fastest fire rates and time to kill in the entire game, and it's at number 41 because it had a very long fire delay that would often get you in trouble. When you pulled the trigger on the HLX, you had to hold it there for a second and let it spool up before the bullets started coming out. Now, for a sniper assault rifle, that's annoying, but for an SMG, that's devastating. Think about it. SMGs are for running around, getting in people's faces, so how are you supposed to do that when your gun has to spool up like a turbo? You literally couldn't rush with the SMG, and that defeated the purpose. The stats were insane, but the fire delay brought it down to number 41. At number 39, let's jump into it. The Shiva in Black Ops 3. Now, this is one of those guns that it has a fan club. It always appears whenever I talk about it. It's a semi-auto rifle, has a painfully low fire rate, but extremely high damage. Now, by default, it will kill with 2 bullets from practically any range. If you throw the high caliber attachment on there, it becomes a one-shot kill to the head, which is very, very intimidating. It was a high-skill weapon. I mean, it was. That fire rate would punish you hard if you missed your first shot, but if you aimed high and stayed on target, it was one of those get-good weapons. At number 38, the Carve .2 in Black Ops Cold War. 3-round burst rifle added a little ways into the life cycle, but it remained perfectly viable. When it was first added, it was a tad OP in Warzone, but after a patch or two, it's in a good place now. It's just a solid, reliable rifle. And, I mean, it will get the job done from anywhere, mid to long range, but that burst delay will get you in trouble if somebody tries to rush you. Stick to mid-range, you'll probably be okay with this one. At number 37, the Type 95 in Modern Warfare 3. Speaking of OP burst weapons, it was completely broken on launch day in MW3, but after the accuracy was nerfed into the ground, you never saw it again. The rifle could one burst from insane distances. It could even two-shot people up close. I mean, the damage is still good to this day, but the accuracy, like I said, nerfed into the ground. It is. I'm giving it the number 37 spot because the damage is so great, but that poor accuracy, it honestly clipped its wings. At number 36, the SVU AS in Black Ops 2. I've said a few times this gun was underrated. It's a semi-auto sniper, good fire rate, low recoil, big default magazine. It was very powerful if you sat back with it, but most people didn't want to do that because it wasn't very dignified to play that way in Black Ops 2. If you played the SVU to its strengths, it's an extremely powerful weapon. If you tried to rush people and use it like a ballista or a DSR, you're probably gonna have a bad time. At number 35, the P90 in Modern Warfare 2. Now, it was often overshadowed by other ridiculous weapons in this game. That doesn't mean it was bad. It fired at over 900 rounds per minute, would kill in 4 to 5 shots with no stopping power. It gave it a very competitive time to kill compared to the other autos in the game. Recoil, little bouncy, but it was an SMG. You were going to just stick to close quarters combat anyway, meaning you weren't going to notice that recoil as much. It wasn't as versatile as guns like the UMP or the ACR, but it was fun to use. At number 34, the Graza in Black Ops Cold War. It was one of the first DLC weapons added to Cold War, and it ended up being popular. Bullpup assault rifle, solid fire rate, good handling speeds. It was a nice counterpart to weapons like the QBZ and the XM4. It wasn't top tier, but it was perfectly viable, and since you have the whole gunsmith at your disposal, you could tweak it however you wanted. At number 33, the KSG in Modern Warfare 3. Now, this version of it wasn't as ridiculous as the Black Ops 2 version, but it was fun. like its younger brother, older brother, whatever, the Modern Warfare 3 version had a great ammo capacity. It had good fire rate, very intimidating sound effects. It was buckshot, it wasn't a slug, but the damage in the range was still very hard to go up against if you weren't ready for it. Plus, like I said, the ammo capacity made it good for group fights. You could just blast people off their feet. At number 32 today, the DSR-50 in Black Ops 2. Now, if we're talking about the original version of the gun, it would be top 5. But we're not. We're talking about guns how they exist today. It gets the number 32 spot. Bolt-action sniper, strong, almost always killing with a single bullet, but it used to be better, so much better. The fire rate was a lot higher, you could jump from target to target. You guys already know. Treyarch realized they'd gone a little too far and decided to nerf the fire rate, which was one of the most controversial moves a COD developer has ever made. Still a very reliable sniper, but since that fire rate is so low now, it's not nearly as versatile. At number 31, the AUG in Modern Warfare 2019. SMG this time around, a lot of people loved it. It was versatile. It was one of the most customizable weapons in the game, and that's saying something. You could change the ammo type. You could make it more like an LMG. You could make it an AR. You could rush with it like an SMG. You could do anything. A lot of people slept on the Modern Warfare AUG because it was kind of crap in Warzone, but in standard multiplayer, it was good. At number 30, the ABR-223 in Black Ops 4. Three-round burst rifle wasn't as popular as some others in the game, but it was strong, and if you used it, you knew. The fire rate was good for a burst weapon. The damage per shot was pretty high. Now, one burst kills were somewhat a rarity with the gun, but the raw damage it was pumping out was pretty impressive, and you could clean up entire teams if you knew how to operate it. I think the ABR was good. I think it's a good way to crack into the top 30 today. At number 29, the R3K in IW. Three-round burst energy rifle had some insane damage potential, and while the fire rate was low, the time to kill was fantastic. Three shots came out very quickly. There was no recoil. You could beam people from impressive distances with this thing. It wasn't one of the best burst weapons in COD history, but it was a good choice for medium-sized maps, and there was even a handful of variants people were really desperate to get their hands on, but thank goodness variants are gone, right? At number 28, the P90 in COD 4. The original P90 is still one of the best in COD history, if you ask me. 937 rounds per minute, didn't kick much at all, had a super tight hip fire spread, allowed you to roll with steady aim and spray people down without even actually having a game. Whew, it was a beast. The only reason it's down here is because it struggled at mid-range, where some of the other SMGs like the MP5 and the AK-74U were still competitive, but it was still a beast. At number 27, the Vepr in Ghost. I like this gun. It was one of the better SMGs in Ghost, but it was overshadowed by the MTAR-X and the Ripper. It would kill in 3 to 5 shots by default. It had a 42-round mag by default, and there was no recoil. It was a good gun for mid-range combat. It kind of served as that middle ground between an assault rifle and an SMG. It wasn't going to outgun top-tier SMGs, but it was a nice choice for medium-sized maps or stealthy players who like to stay off the radar. At number 26, Swordfish in Black Ops 4. Have you ever seen the movie Swordfish with John Travolta? Clearly meant to be a counterpart to the M8A1 and M8A7, so did it live up to it? Kinda. Four-round burst tactical rifle could one-burst people from most ranges due to the longer time to kill a Black Ops 4 and the slower time between bursts, though it was hard to use. If we're just looking at stats, it was insane. But when you apply those stats the way Black Ops 4 was played, you didn't see it very much. At number 25 today, the XR2 in Black Ops 3. I've said a few times that people slept on the gun. Three-round burst rifle unlocked pretty early in Black Ops 3's progression. It was largely overshadowed by the M8A7, but when you played around with it, you could see the potential. It had good range, it could one-burst people, plus the recoil was 100% vertical, so if you threw on high caliber and you aim for the chest, it was going to be good times. Fire rate was a little low, so it was kind of crappy at close range, but when people realized how to use it, it was good. At number 24 today, the Razorback in Black Ops 3. Who remembers the Black Ops 3 beta when it was broken? The game came out, people forgot about it. It was a middle ground between an assault rifle and SMG, and that's what I loved about it. The fire rate was low, yes, but the damage was fantastic, and there was no recoil on this gun. If you were challenging people at close range and constantly rushing, you were going to have a bad time. But if you played stealthy, smart, and mid-range, it was fantastic. You had to play the Razorback to its strengths, but if you did, it was a great gun. It was one of my favorites. At number 23, the FFAR-1. And Black Ops Cold War. It's a weird one to rank because it's been buffed and nerfed so many times, and I'm making this video late August 2021, and right now it's in a good spot, but it could get nerfed next week, and this is going to make me sound stupid. Good fire rate, solid close damage. I mean, it struggles at longer range, which is a little weird because it's an assault rifle, but maybe it's for the sake of balancing. I don't know. I think upper mid-tier is a good spot for this gun. At number 22... the Ram 7 in Modern Warfare 2019. This is the 2019 version of the classic TAR-21. Now, it wasn't quite as good as the Golden Age gun, but it was viable. fired at almost 900 rounds per minute, killed the littlest three shots. It gave it an extremely competitive time to kill, and since it's an AR, decent range values. It could keep up with other weapons beyond close quarters. Now, it's not the best gun in the game or anything like that, but it was extremely strong and completely viable. And surprisingly, it was good in Warzone if you kitted it for max range. Give it another shot. At number 21, the MTAR in Black Ops 2. Your starting assault rifle in the game that caused people to pass right over it. And man, did they miss out. Good fire rate, bouncy recoil, but it was okay. Terrific damage, killed in three shots up close, four anywhere else. In fact, when you get down to raw stats, it actually had a faster time to kill than the full autos in Black Ops 2, although it wasn't as easy to use. That's why it wasn't as popular. I loved it though. Such a smooth feeling gun. And this next one, you're gonna hate me, but I love it. The M-Field in Black Ops 1. I've said many times, I love this gun. Now, I don't think it was top tier, but it was high tier. It was probably a top 10 weapon in the original Black Ops. Fired at 750 rounds per minute. Could kill in 3 to 4 shots. It gave it a pretty average time to kill in Black Ops 1, but where it shined was the feel and the accuracy. Had super clean iron sights, very manageable recoil. Yes, it wasn't as accurate as some other rifles in Black Ops 1, but it felt super smooth, and that 3 to 4 shot kill made it consistent. I love the gun. I was an advocate for this gun from the beginning, and if you got it level 5, you got plenty of time to use it. If you still play Black Ops 1 somehow, go back and try the Enfield. I know it's an ugly gun and people passed over it, but it is super slept on. At number 19, the P90 in Modern Warfare 2019. This gun is extremely good in core multiplayer. Little iffy Warzone, but Modern Warfare standard multiplayer, yep. Fired very quickly, didn't hit very hard, but it was accurate, had a lot of good attachments too. Plus, bonus, you could put a 50 round mag by default on there. Okay, never mind, it was 50 round mag by default. You didn't have to put it on there. Anyway, whatever, you didn't have to waste your slots, okay, on ammo. It was fun. At number 18, the Kashka in Black Ops 4. Bolt action sniper, one of the most popular in Black Ops 4, thanks to the super similar traits to other fan favorites like the Ballista and the Intervention. It handled quickly. It had a good fire rate. You had to aim a little high in order to get that one shot kill, but it was satisfying. There was even an operator mod that made it even closer to classic snipers by keeping the hip fire spread tight even when you aim down the sight so you could no scope even easier. Yeah! It was a good sniper. Since it was a bullpup, pretty solid spot on the list. At number 17, the OG TAR 21 in Modern Warfare 2. One of the most slept on guns in this game. Featured a great fire rate, super clean sights, fantastic damage per shot. So why didn't people use it? The recoil. It was bouncy. It was difficult to use beyond close range. If you were using stopping power and you hit all your shots, it was one of the best in MW2, but since other weapons like the ACR and the SCAR were much easier to control, a lot of people passed on it. I loved it. I think it was one of the better bullpup weapons from the golden age of COD. At number 16, the AUG in Black Ops Cold War. Now, the AUG has been, it's been a talking point ever since Cold War came out. This time around, 3-round burst tactical rifle. Caused up a stir in both multiplayer and Warzone. Now, despite it being a tactical rifle, it has a really good handling, and time to kill on the burst was insane. After a string of nerfs, it's in a good spot right now, but it's still a formidable weapon. The burst is easy capable of insta-kills, and handling can be super quick with the right attachments. I mean, the only downside, probably the bullet velocity, kind of sucks, but if you stick to mid-range, it's a beast. At number 15 today, the Vesper in Black Ops 3. This is one of the most annoying guns to go up against. It rivaled the Scorpion Evo in terms of time to kill, and it had that crazy firing sound with it. Fired at 1,200 rounds per minute, people. Would kill in 4 shots up close and 6 at mid-range. Recoil was high, yes. You would rarely kill anyone beyond mid-range, but there was some crazy people who managed to keep it under control and beam people. It had the fastest fire rate in all of Black Ops 3, and the damage kept it popular as a pick through the entire life cycle. If that recoil had even been a little lower, woo! At number 14, the FFAR in Black Ops 3. Now, people were hyped when this gun was added to supply drops, and it didn't disappoint. Futuristic remake of the FAMAS from the original Black Ops. You know what it is. High fire rate, good damage. Little long reload time, pretty strong recoil. It was strong. If you could handle that recoil and fit it right in with the rest of the guns in the game, you were good. Now, it's a shame that you had to pull it from a supply drop. But if you got your hands on it, you knew. At number 13 today, the BOS 14 in Modern Warfare Remastered. DLC assault rifle added a few months into its lifespan. A lot of people called it overpowered. It was never really nerfed. It's still a top tier weapon if you probably never played with it. Good fire rate, high damage, does have some bouncy recoil, it's hard to use, but other than that, time to kill on it was pretty crazy. I mean, it's not the M16, but it was close. It was a really good gun, but it's hard to get excited about it when a DLC weapon in a remastered game comes out. If we got more classic COD remasters, I kind of hope there's no DLC weapons. I really don't. At number 12, The PO6 in Black Ops 3, weird weapon, but once you got the hang of it, devastating. I remember watching Pomage just destroy people with this gun. Three-round burst sniper rifle had to be charged up, which meant you had to predict your enemy's movement. Despite being a three-round burst, you could kill with a single bullet. It took some getting used to, and a lot of people hated it, but there was a sizable chunk of the community who swore by it. I have to give them credit. It was a high-skill weapon. At number 11, the RPR Evo in Infinite Warfare, futuristic remake of the fan favorite Ripper from COD Ghosts, and it was slightly nerfed, but it was still intimidating. You had that fast-firing SMG mode, slower-firing assault rifle mode, both of which were strong. You had one of the best time-to-kills in the entire game, and while the assault rifle mode was underwhelming, it was accurate. It was a good choice for hardcore modes, but since you still had the mobility of an SMG, yeah, people skipped over it in Infinite Warfare, but it was a great bullpup. At number 10, the KSG in Black Ops 2, one of my favorite shotties in COD history. Slug Shotty could get one-shot kills from anywhere. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the KSG might actually have the longest one-shot kill range of any shotgun in COD history. Yes, you had to aim more precisely, but that's what made it so satisfying. The fire rate was high, the damage was insane, the sound effects were super satisfying. This thing thundered through the map when you pulled the trigger, and if you knew someone on the other team was using it, you were a little extra careful rushing into enemy territory. At number 9, the K-Bar 32 in Infinite Warfare. Now, the MV4 was the most used gun in the game, we know that. The K-Bar was close. Compared to the MV4, it fired quicker, it hit slightly lighter, but it had fantastic stats. It kind of reminded me of the TAR 21 in the sense that it fired quick, and if you knew what you were doing, it would demolish lobbies. Plus, the fire rate made it more incapable of competing with the SMGs at close range in that game. It was a good gun. Even though a lot of people didn't care about Infinite Warfare, this one deserved a high spot on the list. At number 8, the AUG in Black Ops 1. I mean, in terms of time to kill, it was actually on par with the FAMAS, but you didn't see it as much because the recoil was harder to control. The FAMAS kicked up and down. The AUG was more side to side, which is not what you want from a gun in Call of Duty. With that being said, though, a lot of people love this version of it. They even preferred it to the FAMAS. Put Tiger Camo on it and it ups your KD automatically. Wasn't quite top tier because of that recoil pattern, but the stats were impressive. I mean, you could go toe-to-toe with FAMAS users up front. At number 7, the Rajin EMX in Infinite Warfare. A burst SMG that was added, I think, later in half it, or maybe halfway through the life cycle, so you may be forgiven if you didn't even know it was here. It was insane. Despite being an SMG, it had the range of an M16, which made it super easy to one burst people while zipping around and jumping from wall to wall. The fire rate? A little slow for an SMG, but you were dealing so much damage, who cared? It was insane. If you never experienced it because you skipped Infinite Warfare, maybe you quit early on it, go look at some videos of it. It was absolutely ridiculous. At number 6, the COD Ripper. The Ripper in COD Ghosts, one of the first DLC weapons ever put in a COD game. It was added pretty shortly after the launch of Ghosts, and it took over. I believe this was also the first true hybrid weapon in COD history, as you could hit a single button, swap it between assault rifle and SMG mode, which both were good. The versatility of the Ripper was the main draw, and both versions of the gun were top tier. There was one other bullpup in COD Ghosts that I think was better than the Ripper. We'll talk about it soon. At number 5, the Maddox RFB in Black Ops 4, one of the only guns you ever saw online. I mean, you really, so many people. Fast-firing assault rifle, low recoil, moderate damage, pretty quick handling. You mix all into a pot, you got a weapon with a fantastic time to kill in pretty much every situation in the game. Up close, it would compete with SMGs. At range, it had a better time to kill than other ARs. It was a good rifle. It probably deserved a nerf a long time ago. Heck, it probably deserved a nerf before the game ever came out. At number 4, the BAL 27 in Advanced Warfare. Now, whenever Sledgehammer releases a game with an OP weapon, people immediately compare it to the BAL 27 because that gun completely broke the game. Unlocked at level 1. Hands down the best gun in the entire game. That's a joke. The assault rifle, I mean, it was easy to use. Had a good time to kill. And there was a laundry list of variants that made it even better. Which one did you like? The Obsidian Steed, the Inferno, the Royalty? It didn't matter which variant you got. They were all busted. At number 3, the MTAR X in Ghosts. This has to be one of the best SMGs in COD history. It was an SMG variant of the TAR 21, but better in every way. Better mobility, better close range damage, still had the range of an assault rifle. It was one of the most used weapons in competitive play back in the Ghost days, and a lot of players say it's one of the best guns in COD history for tournaments. At number 2, the FAMAS in Modern Warfare 2. Now, a while back, I said this was the best assault rifle in COD history, and I got heat for that. Maybe I was just trying to stir the pot, I don't know, but I think the gun was insane. Three-round burst that fired at 1,000 rounds per minute and only needed 2 bullets to kill. It was literally the COD M16, but even better. It had super clean iron sights, almost no recoil. It made it extremely easy to one-burst people from unfair distances. It was absurd. No doubt in my mind, it belongs almost at the top. But at number one today, the best bullpup ever made in COD history, no shocker, the FAMAS in Black Ops 1. I mean, it dominated the game. It's one of the most infamous weapons in COD history because it practically is the only gun you ever saw. It fired quick, it killed in three shots, it had a better time to kill than everything in the game, regardless of the scenario. It beat the SMGs at close range, it beat the rifles at long range. Now, yes, the recoil was heavy, but it was all vertical. You could learn that pattern and control it. It was powerful. It blows my mind that Treyarch never nerfed the damage. Yes, they nerfed the accuracy, but since the time to kill was never changed, the player base just adapted. I adored the gun, and man, the way it sounded, whew! It was the best. To me, it was the best bullpup in COD history. Let me know where you guys disagree and agree. Thanks for making it to the end of the video, and I'll see you soon.